there are few thrills that can compete with the thrill of scientific discovery. My absolute favorite story about important moments in science, even today, is the story of the telescope and the person who first wielded it with earth-shattering effect, Galileo. Galileo didn't even invent the telescope. He heard about it as news from the Netherlands traveled to Italy. He put his own gizmo together, increased its magnification, and oh my, the perfect Aristotelian sun suddenly had blotches on it. Our moon had craters, and Jupiter's moons danced around that planet in systematic ways. All this pointed, of course, in one difficult direction. We were not the center of the universe. Copernicus was right. Of course, these discoveries didn't line up with what ordinary people thought, but Galileo had an instrument. You can imagine the defiant Galileo thinking, "I'll shove their faces into those lenses, and once they see, they will have to believe." 400 years later, we're at a new frontier. Instead of only looking outward to the farthest reaches of the universe, we're also looking inside the mind. Your brain and mine has more individual cells, neurons, in it than all the stars in our galaxy. And guess what? The universe inside our heads seems to be just as fascinating and perplexing, sometimes just as frightening, as those worlds so far away must have seemed in 1610. Mind scientists like myself, we too have our instruments. Sometimes they're just clever little questions that can be posed to people. Sometimes we observe how quickly they make their decisions. Sometimes we directly measure brain activity. These are our telescopes. I'm Mahzarin Banaji. I'm a professor of experimental psychology at Harvard University. For the past 35 years, I've had the great fortune of studying two of the most complex systems that we know of, the human mind and the social world in which the human mind does its work. I study how we think about other people and ourselves, how decisions we make are influenced by things that we have no clue about. Small discoveries from my own lab have shown us something interesting, that we may not always be the objective, rational, good people that we think we are. And that's not because we are bad people, but rather because our minds are built to do the job of surviving in a world that looked nothing like the one that we confront today. Outsmarting Human Minds is a project designed to bring you the best information science allows us at this time to understand and hopefully outsmart our minds. Whether you're a parent, an educator, somebody in the world of healthcare, business, law enforcement, whatever you happen to do, your thoughts and feelings about yourself and the others around you are significant determinants of your life and your work. My hope is a simple one, that with learning about the mind will come an appreciation of how it got built over the course of evolution, how it was influenced by culture, how it serves us well and fails us, and how we can outsmart it to become the decision makers that we want to be.